Disclaimer, this is all for fun and entertainment reasons. This is definitely not for educational. I just love learning about astrology and zodiac signs, so I wanted to make a fun ASMR video. Be sure to like and subscribe and tell me what your sign is in the comments and if anything I have said today resonates with you. So, firstly, I'm just going to be talking about fire signs in general. Also, I'm getting all of my information from the internet and different websites. This isn't from my brain. I'm just using different astrology websites, so please tell me if I have anything extremely wrong. So, the element of fire is represented in the zodiac through Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius. These signs truly uplift the strength of the sun, and each individual born as one of these sun signs has an assignment to nurture and cherish their emotional side. They often have to be trained for compassion and a deeper understanding of other people, and have basic problems in relationships triggered by their need to give more than they should to those who didn't ask for anything. Each fiery individual has to use their energy solely on their own life, unless if somebody asks for their advice and engagement. Of all three, Sagittarius is the most giving, for they are at the end of this fire trine, already learned so much with a strong life philosophy and numerous good intentions. Like fire itself, fire signs tend to be passionate, dynamic, and temperamental. Fire can keep you warm, or it can do great destruction. While fire burns out quickly without fuel to keep it going, it can also regenerate its power from the ashes. A single spark can set off a forest fire. As a result, fire signs need to be nurtured and managed carefully. Okay. Strengths: courageous, determined, confident, enthusiastic, optimistic, honest, and passionate. Their weaknesses is that they are impatient, moody, short-tempered, impulsive, and aggressive. Aries likes comfortable clothes, on leadership roles, physical challenges, individual sports, and they dislike inactivity, delays, and work that does not use one's talents. As the first sign in the zodiac, the presence of Aries always marks the beginning of something energetic and turbulent. They are continuously looking for dynamic speeds and competition, always being the first in everything from work to social gatherings. Thanks to its ruling planet Mars and the fact it belongs to the element of fire, Aries is one of the most active zodiac signs. It is in their nature to take action sometimes before they think about it well. The sun in such high dignity gives them excellent organizational skills. So you'll rarely meet an Aries who isn't capable of finishing several things at once, often before lunch break. I'm not sure if that means they're organized. I think that just more means they can be very active, because I know a lot of Aries who definitely aren't organized. I feel like they're organized in their own way. So they are not organized compared to a Virgo sense of organization. Strong personalities born under this sign have a task to fight for their goals, embracing togetherness and teamwork through this incarnation. Okay, moving on from Aries to Sagittarius. Sorry, not Sagittarius. We're going to do Leo. So Aries to Leo. Their quality is fixed. Their colors are gold, yellow, and orange. I think Aries should have more colors than red, but that's okay. I'll give Aries a dusty red, a dusty rust in red. So Leo's colors are gold, yellow, and orange. Their day is Sunday. Their ruler is the sun. Greatest compatibility is with Aquarius and Gemini. According to this website, their dates are from July 23rd to August 22nd. Leo's traits, their strengths are creative, passionate, generous, warm-hearted, cheerful, humorous. Their weaknesses are arrogant, stubborn, self-centered, lazy, and inflexible. They like theater. Being admired, expensive things, bright colors, and fun with friends. They dislike being ignored, facing difficult reality, and not being treated like a king or queen. Yeah, I used to be best friends with the most stereotypical Leo you can think of, and she was all of those things. So that was pretty accurate. She really resonated with her sun sign, I guess, of being a Leo, which ultimately led to our demise. But anyway, people born under the sign of Leo are natural born leaders. They are dramatic, creative, self-confident, dominant, and extremely difficult to resist. They're able to achieve anything they want in any area of life they commit to. There is a specific strength to a Leo and their king of the jungle status. Leo often has many friends, for they are generous and loyal, self-confident, and attractive. This is a sun sign capable of uniting different groups of people and leading them as one towards a shared cause, and their healthy sense of humor makes collaboration with other people even easier. I think difficulties arise, though, when the Leo becomes too self-centered. To the element of fire. This makes them warm-hearted, in love with life, true, trying to laugh and have a good time. They're able to use their mind to solve even the most difficult problems, and they will easily take initiative in resolving various complicated situations. Leo worships this fiery entity in the sky, the sun, quite literally as well as metaphorically. They are in search of self-awareness and constant growth of ego. Aware of their desires and personality, they can easily ask for anything they need, but could just as easily unconsciously neglect the needs of other people in their chase for personal gain or status. When a Leo representative becomes too fond and attached to their achievements and the way other people see them, they become an easy target, ready to be taken down. Sometimes hold a grudge against Leos. I think it's because I'm a Pisces and we can be so different sometimes. And maybe their extrovertedness and their ability to stand out I tend to shy away from that. Or maybe because I'm a Pisces, I want to be more like a Leo, so I'm not sure. But anyway, I'm going to move on to Sagittarius now. Sag. So, their quality is mutable. That's interesting. Like Pisces, their color is blue. Their day is Thursday. Their ruler is Jupiter. And apparently their overall compatibility is with Gemini and Aries. Their dates range from November 22nd to December 21st. Sagittarius strengths are generous, idealistic, and they have a great sense of humor. Their weaknesses is that they can promise more than they can deliver. They're very impatient, and they will say anything no matter how undiplomatic. Sagittarius likes freedom, travel, philosophy, and being outdoors. Sagittarius dislikes clingy people, being constrained, off-the-wall theories. That's so specific. Off-the-wall theories. Curious and energetic, Sagittarius is one of the biggest travelers among all zodiac signs. Their open mind and philosophical view motivates them to wander around the world in search of the meaning of life. Sagittarius is an extrovert. I don't like when certain websites or people will put an extrovert or introvert label on a certain sign, a certain sun sign, because I think it really depends on the moon and the ascending and the sun sign as well. Like, I feel like you can be an extroverted Pisces. Maybe Sagittarius tend to be more extroverted, but I feel like you can also be an introverted Sagittarius. They're optimistic and enthusiastic and like changes. Sagittarius born are able to transform their thoughts into concrete actions, and they will do anything to achieve their goals. Like a typical fire sign. Like the other fire sign, Sagittarius needs to be constantly in touch with the world to experience as much as possible. The ruling planet of Sagittarius is Jupiter, the largest planet of the zodiac. Big, 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 big. Their enthusiasm has no bounds. Their enthusiasm has no bounds, and therefore people born under the Sagittarius sign possess a great sense of humor and an intense curiosity. Freedom is their greatest treasure because only then can they freely travel and explore different cultures and philosophies. Because of their honesty, Sagittarius born are often impatient and tactless when they need to say or do something. So it's important to learn to express themselves in a tolerant and socially acceptable way. I have actually never met a Sagittarius or knowingly met one. Like, I've never been close with one, so I can't speak to the accuracy of this. But yes, that is the last fire sign. I think I'm going to do air next and end in earth, so stay tuned for those. I hope you found this video entertaining, / relaxing. I like using the Apple earbuds, just for a lo-fi video. I'm working on my background noise and my whispering, and hopefully limiting the amount of pops and blowing into the mic. So, I hope you have a wonderful morning, afternoon, or night. Thank you so much for watching, and be sure to give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. I'm probably going to make more. Let me know if you are any of these signs, and if you agree or disagree with anything